they have leased and a GUI builder called Designer comes with Qt, and it's really convenient to use. Somebody asked me when to use the Designer versus when to lay out the GUI with code. I'd say if you get the hang of it, you know, always lay out the GUI with the Designer. It makes it a lot easier to lay out nice looking GUIs. You can position things where you want, and I mean graphically, so you can see what you see is what you get. And also, it makes it pretty easy also to access the layout managers, which position things relative to one another so that things look nice as they're empowering you to find it. So let's open that up and see what that means. Of course, everything you can do with Designer, you can do with pure Qt code, but it's just a little bit easier when you can see the results immediately. All right, so also questions I get, the difference between main window versus widget. A main window is a widget, so anything that a widget can do, a main window can also do. A main window also is good if you wanted to add stuff like a file menu or a toolbar, something like that. Let's just make a widget, and let's see how things get moving. So if we put a push button on there, it shows up where we want it, right? That's a little bit harder to do with pure code, because if you want your window to be a certain size, you wanted this to appear in a particular place, you'd have to enter the pixel values where you want it. Okay? You can also resize it. But you can also do things like adding layouts. So if you want everything that shows up on here to be added like one after the other, vertically, so what we do is we click this vertical layout here on the left. We can drag it over and drop it on our main window or widget. Oh, excuse me. That's not the way I wanted to do it. This is the way I wanted to do it. Right click this thing here. We're going to choose layout and layout vertically. So it's in the right click layout, and then you can select which kind of layout you want. So you notice how immediately the button snaps to the center. But what's more important is that when we add additional things to it, another push button, a tool button, checkbox, they all get added vertically, and they're equally given equal amounts of space by default. You can change that behavior, but by default, they're giving equal amounts of space. Also, all the buttons have their own rules about how wide they should be when they're allowed to take up available space. You can change that as well. But let's see how quickly we can change this to make everything laid out horizontally instead. So we right-click it, we lay it out instead horizontally. We can right-click it, we can change to lay everything out by a grid. And so that allows us to put things in grid-like sort of pattern. And it decides for you what sort of grid you're going for. It tries to infer what you're trying to do. Yeah, and there's form layout. But you can play with those to get the desired effect, but more importantly, I like to lay out things. So for instance, there was the animation. We wanted it to look something like this. We wanted the animator, actually it's in the assignment for this time, I think you're creating the animating thing. Okay, so I want there to be some sort of window like this, and then a push button here, and then a slider here. We can get that sort of layout too, but that's very easy to lay out initially, right? We can just find our regular old widget. Because this widget here is, I want to break the layout. This widget here is going to end up, I'm going to subclass that. This is something that I'm going to end up drawing on, right? So I'm just adding a regular widget. We can see how to do that later. Well, let's see now that I wanted to add the button, push button, and a slider, horizontal slider. Okay, so then we can preview things. Or preview. But when I resize it, it's not going to resize. Not by default. If we wanted to change that, how can we, what do you think we want to happen when we make this GUI bigger? How do we want the resize to happen? Do we want the, if I make it vertically expanded, what happens to the push button? What should happen to the slider?
Yeah. Push button and slider stay the same height.
Yeah. They should probably stay the same height. They don't themselves get taller. What else about it?
Well, the widget gets.
So you meant this widget here. Yeah, that widget gets bigger as well. So kind of what you want to happen is that it needs to slide down to the bottom, and that's to take that space. Okay, how about when we scale horizontally? I'll give you a ticket just a second. What happens when we scale horizontally? What should happen then?
When we want to move it all the way up, we compress it all the way up. We do not want the push button in the second scale. We want it to stay constant.
Oh, after a certain point, you think you want it to stay constant? Well, how about let's just assume that it's got a certain minimum size. Let's say we want to make it bigger.
We probably want the push button stuff to go to the center.
Okay. Do you want, you think, really? Okay, so you think that these guys should go over this, we want to move these towards the center like that? That's a possibility. That's fine. But I don't know, most GUIs, I think that we all probably have interacted with GUIs a lot and have certain expectations for how things would go. And my first inclination was actually a little bit different. I wouldn't want these to move. I'd probably want the push button to stay at the left. And I think that I would want the slider, personally, to get bigger because, for instance, let's take a look at Windows Media Player. Or actually VLC. So VLC is a movie player. And notice how that when we resize VLC up, down, right? These buttons and the slider, this is going to be basically be a slider, those move with it, just like we wanted to. But also, notice how it's not like the slider doesn't move to the center. The buttons don't move to the center. The slider just expands. The buttons stay the same size. So if I were trying to replicate the behavior of a typical movie player, I think that's what I want. So you can always look at similar programs. If you want to figure out how your GUI should be laid out, try to find an analog to what you're looking for in something that's already created. All right, the question is how to achieve that behavior, right? So if we were to use a vertical layout manager, let's see what would happen. Forget how to do this, but I think that we can change the background color of this thing to white so we can see it better. Background, auto fill background. Yeah, there we go. That's we can change the color. I used to know how to do that. You can see this a little bit better now. Maybe if we go right there. Trying to make it so that you can see this a little bit better. We're gonna have to live with that for now. You can tell where it is by these visual boxes that I can click and drag. Let's see what happens if I were to add a vertical layout to this. See, it pushes the push button above the slider, and that's not really what we want. We kind of want the push button to stay always to the left of the slider, and the slider is going to expand, right? Likewise, if we added we laid this all out horizontally, that's also not what we want for sure. I'm not even sure what happened. Oh yeah, it looks like here is where the widget went. The push button's there, and then the slider filled up all the available space. That's not what we want either. We kind of want a combination of both. What we really want is we kind of want, at the bottom, we've got some sort of group of things that we want to lay out horizontally. So here's the push button, and here's the slider. And when we move this, we don't want this to get any bigger, but we do want this whole group to expand. We probably also want the button to stay the same size within there. But this kind of looks like some sort of horizontal layout to me. This part here, the main part though, we've got our big widget here. We want that to be the thing that expands, but we want these to stay laid out stacked vertically. So we want a hybrid of sorts. And we can do that. It turns out that another use for a widget is just as this lightweight container box that I put around here. I put that box around these two buttons. You can actually do that. So let's break this layout. Let's undo, actually. Okay, so this is how I had it originally. And I don't think that I have any layout manager in that. What I'm going to do, I'm going to move these, that button and that slider just out of the way for now. I'm going to add a new widget, a regular old widget. And the only purpose of that widget is that I'm going to use it to group my button and the slider. And I do that by putting the push button, clicking and dragging, notice how it turns a dark gray, into there. And then I push, I bring this, and I bring that into there as well. This thing, we said, I'm going to right click it. Now, when I click right click in here, I'm clicking inside this widget. Okay, there was a widget that I have the push button and the slider, and I right click inside there. I'm going to lay out that widget horizontally. And we'll see how to make it a little bit bigger, right? Oh, look, that's already happening kind of how we want it. But we'll have to figure out how to make this take up all available space horizontally. But then we also said we want this always to stay on top of this and things to grow proportionally. We can right click and lay out the main window widget. We can lay that out vertically. All right, by default, what that does is it takes the push button and the slider now fill up all horizontal space automatically. And this widget here, if we were to click on it, can't quite see, each of them gets equal amounts. It tries to equal everything out. But we wanted something just a little bit different. We wanted to make sure that this widget here is always small. Now I can't click and drag it at this point because the layout manager is in control. I've specified that this window is supposed to be laid out by the layout manager. I am no longer in control of that. I have to break the layout for that to happen. So what we need to do is set a few of the settings of things. So there's a few different ways we can do it. And honestly, I get by with the layout manager because I haven't taken a lot of time to really learn the ins and outs of it because I don't lay out GUIs professionally. And nor do you at this point. You just want to get something done with the computer. You lay it out good enough. So I don't require you to be an expert in this, but there are a few different ways we can do it. We can set the maximum size of this widget. See if there's a maximum size property here? We can set that. Let's set the maximum height to 50. There we go. Problem solved. That's one way to do it. We just set the maximum size of this widget to 50, and now if we are going to, yeah, resize everything, everything pretty much resizes like we want. Maybe we should make this maximum size of this just a little bit bigger, but there's another way of doing it. See, this push button got squashed when we did that, and this slider might have changed a little bit. We probably want them to stay in their preferred size, whatever size they are by default. I didn't really intend for that to change. So there's other ways we can do it. So let's bring this back and make it whatever it was before, really big. And what you can do is set the size policy. So right now, the vertical policy is preferred. If we set this to maximum, there's another way of getting it. And it's kind of complicated to explain. Every object or every widget has its own preferred size, how big it wants to be, based on, say, the text inside the push button. There's a preferred size it should be. There's a default font size. And there's an amount of text to be placed in, so it knows how much space to add around that to make the button. The button has a preferred size. And what this is saying is that the policy is such that the preferred size of the push button is its maximum size. It cannot become bigger than the preferred size. You're allowed to squash it and make it smaller if other components really need the space for some reason, but you're not allowed to make it any bigger. And so that's what limits this thing to be a maximum size of however big it should be. So that's not going to expand anymore. And just by, let's see, I think that we also took care of everything horizontal is working just as we want it to be, because the push button already has a policy. Look at the horizontal policy of the button here. Let's see. It says minimum is the horizontal policy. Is that consistent? There's other different, you can do other policies with it. You can just play around with them to see how it reacts, to be honest, rather than memorizing what each of them does. And you can see how different policies will change the way the button will resize itself. So that's how you get around GUIs, right? think in terms of blocks of things that you want to lay out, whether those blocks themselves, how do you want to lay out the blocks, vertically or horizontally, and each sub-block, lay those out vertically or horizontally, and then set the size policies, and you can end up with a really nice responsive GUI that changes sizes of all components, how you expect them to. So that is something I'm not going to teach in great detail. I just want you to know it. I actually, the first time through the class, everything was just laid out by positioning on the screen. I didn't go into layout managers at all. This is just something for you to know that you can play around with and learn by playing around with it. Things you want me to try with this? Yeah.
So you also have the option, like under the layouts, to like. Just like place the layout and then place things in it, like on the.
Oh, this lesson. Over here.
Yeah, is there an advantage to doing it that way?
Actually, I've not gotten that to work.
Okay.
I don't know how that works. I haven't also, another thing, I haven't looked at the code to see what it's doing. I know a little bit about using layouts and coding them in. So I actually don't know what the difference is programmatically when it generates the code from the UI file. Whether it does those two things the same way or not. I'm guessing not, because I wasn't able to get it to work the way I expected it to. It was a lot easier to just right-click things and lay out than adding them over from the left. Good thought. Let me take it. Yeah?
So, this is more of a clarification on the operation things, but there's no way we can use Qt Designer and actually train it to do the, like, respond to a function, right? Like, so we can't. Is there any way we
no.
can teach push buttons to be like.
Who's taking Java? Who's taking PIC 28? Actually, who's taking Java with me? Okay, so a few people took Java with me. There's NetBeans, and the NetBeans is an IDE kind of like our spider, but it has a built-in GUI filter tool. And you can right-click things, and not just lay them out, you can right-click and say, like, the signal of my widget should be connected to a slot in my code. It will automatically create a function for you, a slot for you, and you can just type in what you want to do. It already passes, or if there's an event or something, you can right click and say, I want to say what happens when there's a mouse click event, and it creates the, overrides the function for you. It's really very easy. So that would be very convenient, but GUI Designer does not do that. And for that reason, I somewhat prefer Java for making GUIs, even though Python overall, I think, is a much more convenient language. It's just a tool that, you know, the IDE, we have a separate environment that we have to do all this in. And we've got a separate UI file, we have to use a command line tool to turn it into a PI file. Like, it is complicated. It's more complicated than I think it needs to be. It's just nobody's taken the time to make a really nice integrated development environment, truly integrated, that has the capability to lay out GUIs and add that stuff. It's just not there. There might be some out there, but they might be able to pay for them, I guess. Other questions? Yeah?
Can you just quickly go over how you made the layout to begin with again? Like, when you press autofill and it fills something, but mine's still just a grid.
Sorry, I don't think I did any autofill. Oh, well, the autofill. Oh, sorry, yeah, I did. Sorry. Here we go. So we just wanted to. That was not a required step, okay? I brought this widget on here. And I was trying to make it white, and if I play around with it a few more seconds, I can make it white so you can see it a little bit better. But what I did was, once I brought this widget over, I clicked and dragged it on. Once I did that, I found background, and I said autofill background. And there's some other property here that controls the color of that background, and I'll find it while you guys are taking the quiz and show you that. Remember that when I use this widget, I'm actually going to need to promote it. You saw this in the videos. I promote it to whatever the name of the class is that I want that widget to be. I usually call it Canvas, and that's going to be in another file, et cetera. So I write Canvas, and then, you know, whatever my file name is. And then that changes it so that it's something that I should. Would you go ahead and are there more questions, or do you want to take the quiz now? After the quiz, I'm going to set you loose on your assignment, and I can show people little things up here. If you're interested, you can come up and talk to me, or I can come around. All right, the quiz password is simply GUI, G-U-I-L, capital,